Check out the other live posts that I posted like two, I guess. This will be the third one. And it's really a three. Yeah, 3-1. But yo, I'm all sweaty. It's hot as fuck in here. Whew. I'm gonna have to do the no shirt today, because it's getting hot. I would open the thing, but then neighbors will start complaining, and I don't really feel like turning it down. That'll just make me angry. So. But let me get in tune, though, because I'm not in tune. And let me kick my shoes off, because that's probably one of the reasons why I'm so hot. Hot tamales, hot tamales. Machine Gun. I have not played Voodoo Child today, and I have not played Angel, so I might have to give you all that. Winter is coming, shit. Fuck winter. I'm going through the fall. The falls. Sheesh. Let me tell y'all something. The fall. Any Robin Trower? Trower? I think you know that BLT album? Oh, they're watching. No, I'm just fucking around. You know that BLT album? That's from, actually, the Purple Strap was a gift from the beyond. Detach. That's a Taurus thing. You gotta let go. You gotta let go. It's a Taurus and a Scorpio thing. We gotta teach each other. We gotta let go. There's a lot of things in my life that I gotta let go, and I'm just trying to. So you gotta let go of the strap. Let go of the strap. jump off the deep end. I'm just fucking around. I'm just trolling a little bit. So yeah, Voodoo Child and Angel coming up. And Killing Floor. Voodoo Child, Angel, and Killing Floor. So I guess the best order would probably be to bring you up, then to get you down, and come back up. So 1, 2, 3, 4.
Thank you.
Meditated. That's pretty much it. I meditated real well. Had a good little meditation session. So I saw inside of me. I saw outside of me. All of that. So what did I do? Appreciate it. appreciate it for. Another Tony Battle original, Laundry Funk. I've been giving y'all a lot of Tony Battle originals today. So y'all is a... Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you. I think I just messed my hair up in the back, though. I don't know if that was worth it. Anyway. So what's up? What's up? What's up? Oh, my strap. Not my strap, but my cable isn't in all the way. Man, I know this guitar is like, damn. Bruh, chill out. Pick something else. Pick up another guitar. I can see what people are looking, so. Thank you. I will be, I'm actually in the neck picker. I can get in the middle for you. Summer night. Shadowy, glowy figure right now. Actually, to increase this, what I will do is that's what we do. So now I'm really just a big shadow. Really dark outside, but I just made it dark, so this is my layer. Things. Yeah, that's how it is over here too, but you know, you just kind of have to ride with it. You know, the even flow of life. You don't never know, sunny, if you never have rain. I know what you need. Yeah, no. I know what you need. So you gotta get into it like that. Get into it like that. Just, you already know it's coming. You know, that's one thing about it. Every like, that's how you can really tell humans forget. Just by the even flow of the like, even flow of the full moon, the even flow of the tides, the even flow of the seasons. We know the fall is coming, and we know the spring, or you know, we know the fall is coming, and we know the winter is coming. And we act kind of like every year it's the same thing over and over again, you know, and everybody acts like surprised every single year. And it's crazy because I look at it and I'm just like, every year I look at it and like, wow, how are you guys forgetting? Like, not only was it last year, but the year before and the year before that, it was the same shit, and people forget. So you just got to go with the even flow of life, man. Like, you know, we know the fall is coming. We're in the fall right now. You know, we're gonna fall for a little bit. When we rise back up, though, it's gonna be great. Woo! I should probably get something in my stomach. Oh my God. I should write a song called The Even Flow of the Universe. I'm just kidding. You know, honestly, the winter sucks. I fucking hate the winter, but I just take it as it comes. I can't do nothing about it, so I hate fucking snow. I guess it's cool to see kids like snow, though, or children. Sorry, I don't like to use the word kids. Ghosts have kids. But I guess to see smiling faces on children, or see smiling faces on children, yeah, you know what I'm saying. But to see children smiling and all that, that's cool, so... I guess if there's one silver lining on snow in the wintertime, I guess it's that. And like the children get snow days, so I guess that's cool for them. But as an adult, man, as an adult, the wintertime sucks. Yeah, wintertime sucks. Oh, man. I've been playing for a long time, though. I'm kind of tired. I'm all sweaty and shit, man. I took a shower earlier today, and I feel like I didn't take a shower. I feel like I smell like I didn't take a shower. I feel like I smell like I didn't. That didn't make any sense. But you know what I was trying to say. So, but I guess we're just going to vibe now and just chill until this live goes off. There's nothing else better to do. What's up with y'all? I think there's a peace dealer live chat tonight. You might want to catch that. Oh, that was one last week too, on Monday. I'm picking a scab on my ankle, by the way. And I felt like I picked it last week. And it's still here. Yeah, that's the one thing I really hate about the wintertime, man, is cold fucking fingers. Oh my God, that's the worst. Like, for me, I could not play outside gigs, man. Like, let me tell you this. If it was an outside gig and fucking it was colder than, like, I say 45 degrees or so, I'd be like, man, hell nah. Y'all got some hand warmers or something? Because this shit is not going to cut it. Y'all want me to play like ass, I can play like ass all the way, but that's how that goes, though. So, we're just hanging out, having a good time. I'm picking a scab on my ankle. Actually, I guess I could turn the light on for a little bit just to see if there's any blood. I should give you guys some music real quick. Hey, this is what I'm gonna do. Yabba dabba doo. It's so annoying. I love to play. Well, honestly, I don't know. I'm a mid-ground type of person because I don't like to really sweat all that much. And I'm really sweating right now. So I'm gonna take my shirt off. I don't know, you guys weren't happy about all that buzzing just now, so I'm sorry about that. Hope you can see that light a little bit more. Not one of the humming ones. There's sometimes I do meditate with like just whatever music. I'll see whatever like they say is doing whatever, and I'll be like, okay, I'll pick this one for this particular meditation session. Sometimes I meditate with nothing on. Sometimes I meditate with music. It really depends on what kind of mood I'm going through, honestly. Like, you know, but those do help sometimes. I've had really, really good I've had really powerful sessions with some YouTube music, I guess. So, yeah, you might want to check some of those out. Some of them are really good. I feel like some of them are bullshit, though. So, what I would do is check out the comments. That's what I like to do a lot of times. Oh, it's so dark in here. I like how it's just like my lair. Like the Tony Battle lair. It seems so evil, but like I kind of tame it. Insatsu Kokuryo. So meditation, all that. Yeah, that's all it is, though. But check out the comments on YouTube, because I feel like some of them, especially the ones where you're supposed to sleep to, I feel like some of them like give you potential bad vibes, and then you wake up and you're just like, ah. I don't know personally, but I just, you know, I always keep that mental guard up, I guess. You never know what people's alternative motives are, so. And me being a Scorpio, I have to always keep that guard up and be aware of that. And bring the darkness to the light. Got the light in my hands. What else? What are we talking about? Rose quartz. Yes, rose quartz. Get you some love and abundance, love and appreciation as a Taurus. What is your rising? What did I say your rising was? Because I can start doing your houses now. Doug, what up? Doug, we're just having a good time, just chilling. I posted some earlier things. Now I guess we're just talking about meditation and stuff. I'm here in my lair. So we're just going to chill and just talk and vibe. Actually, I should put some music on in the background so we can get a little bit more vibey. But yeah, this is kind of how I do when I'm not doing anything. We already did one. I forgot what it was, though. I did one for you a while ago. It really depends on you. As far as the chart. Now the wheel, the actual natal wheel, I'm not really good at reading those at all. I can tell you that. But, you know, if you give me the chart that pretty much displays what your sign is, all the aspects and all that stuff, the deacons, the degrees, and the placements and all that, you know, we've already gone through this before, though, so. But as far as taking it, for me, it didn't take all that long, or I guess it kind of did, but didn't really. I don't know. It depends, because I feel like, as a Scorpio, I kind of dive, if I get into something, I'm going to dive deep in as far as I possibly can. So that's just me being me. So I learned it kind of, I don't know how to say, I don't want to say fast, but Some people might consider it fast. I don't know. Who knows? Who cares? But no, I'm sorry. But no, it really just depends on you. Like, how deep you want to go into it. How fast you want to learn. Cool. I'm glad I got it accurate. Yeah, it's all really just channeling information, though. That's really how it is. But no, it's all about how you make it, though. Like, if you just tell yourself, hey, I'm going to learn this as best and as much as possible and get all the sources, then you'll learn it in no time, and it'll be like, wow. Honestly, like, it's been crazy. Like, when you really start to get this stuff, there'll be a lot of, just things become more mystical. And not even mystical, but just, like, what we perceive as mystical, those kind of things become more real. That's what I've learned in my life. Like, I don't know. It's really hard to explain, but, like, the best way I can say it is like this. If you take, like, a supernatural or science fiction movie, and you take everything that we perceive as science fiction, and you turn that into reality, that's kind of the world I live in right now. With all of this stuff that goes on, so yeah, his videos about colors are really good. Or I forgot what he was saying in those videos. Some of them, with a lot of his videos, is cool because, like, I think I've told you this before. A lot of his videos is not really necessarily me learning anything. It's somebody verbalizing what I already knew, or somebody articulating what I already knew. And just kind of putting it into, like, reality. So it's weird. Like, that's one reason why I really kind of gravitate towards his message. And, like, a lot of times why I really post his stuff is because, like, you know, it's kind of really my thoughts, but, like, the things that I have in my brain, or, like, the things I want to say out loud, he's able to really say those things better than I can. So Purple would be like royalty. That also goes into it also goes into pen colors too, by the way. Like, when you're signing contracts, red would be like corrections. That's why, like, when you're in grade school and stuff, those colors that they use for pens, like, when they're using red and they're saying it's wrong or da da da, like, it's really for a reason. It's like, on a metaphysical level, there's a reason for it to be red as opposed to, like, green or blue or purple or orange, or, you know what I'm saying? Like, teachers don't pick, you don't see teachers picking green to let you know that you're wrong, you know? So on a metaphysical plane, we have to really think about, like, what's going on here? Like, why are they using these colors? You know, so get on with that. But purple would be like royalty, third eye, all that. Third eye. Kind of sort of crown. But I guess crown would be more like, I would say crown would be more like a lavender, so to speak. Almost like white, whitish lavender, you know? Yeah, purple would be for pleasures too. Yeah, definitely, actually. You got to think about it. Royalty, when things are royal, is because they're pleasurable, you know? So it's like when green for growth, yeah, green for growth, green for heart, green for love, green for stability, you know. As a Taurus, green is like, that's you, you know. You are green, especially, like, you are the greenest. As a Taurus, you are the greenest of the greenest of the green, of the green. You know, so it's pretty cool. And Taurus is my opposite. And I have an Algol sun. My sun conjuncts Algol. And Algol is actually in the Taurus constellation. It's like 24 degrees. I believe like 24 degrees in the Taurus constellation. But since my sun conjuncted, my sun is a 25. Yeah. My sun is a 25 degrees Scorpio. So my sun conjuncts Algol directly. So I'm literally like the darkest of the dark demons ever. But it's all cool though, because I try to help people and because I love people. I like that there's that red light. I should turn my amp off though. Feel like I'm skating. Ghost Speed Rider. Ghost Speed Rider. I said Speed Rider. It's Speed Racer, isn't it? Ghost Speed Racer. Ghost Speed Racer. Ghost Speed Racer. Go. This is cool chilling though. I like this. Checking out everybody who comes in just to dip out, because I'm not really doing anything. I'm not really playing, so. I feel like it's late though. But I guess that's the fall kicking in. It's a Monday. 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 Some people would say it's better than a Sunday. Fun day. What else are we talking about? Oh, so yeah, when we go into the colors thing, it's all about how you perceive, like when we go back to purple, like you can say that purple will be for pleasures, but it's all about every little thing that you can think of. Like, for me, when I think of purple, I think of royalty. So, but within royalty, why would something be royal? Because it's pleasurable. So, you got to expand on, it's like words have so many dimensions. You got to expand on those dimensions, you know, like, oh man, this is really hard to explain, but that's kind of how you got to approach it. Like, think about the different, like, even every word that you say, like, think of every single dimension that every word plays, because words have vibrations. You know, every time that you speak, they're literally vibrations. It's almost, you got to think of it almost like every time you speak, it's like you're making music. Think of speaking as like music. That's the best way you can think about it. Like, so what are you really, what is the music that you're expressing to the world? Exactly. Music is another form of communication. And when you speak, it's the same thing. It's all vibrations and frequencies. It's all a form of the same thing, you know? Kind of, sort of. See, for me, it's hard to show because I don't have too much. Well, I guess I do have a little bit more fire in me than. But I have a lot of water. So a lot of mine is kind of like mystical and dreamy and stuff. So it's hard for me. I'm already in the world that, like, people are kind of trying to explain about what's going on. So I really can't explain what's going on because I'm in the world. It's you know. But, yeah, that's how you have to think about it. Like, since there's every word or... What the fuck was that? Something hit me. But, I got 30 seconds left. But, yeah, words are vibrations, and you just got to look at the individual aspects, corners, and sides of every word that you think about. So, everybody, I love y'all. Awesome beats, awesome love. I got like 5 seconds, 10 seconds. 2, 1, out of here.